Barry Hall was one of the hard men of AFL, unbreakable and unrelenting. But behind the bravado was deep pain. Tonight, Barry talks about his traumatic childhood and how it's motivated him to be the father he never had.
He wasn't a loving, emotional, supportive dad. I was always looking for his approval, and he treated me like
You might know him as Big Bad Barry Hall, but there's a fair chance you don't know the full story.
Why don't you just tell your kid you love him and give him a hug? It's not hard, I wouldn't think.
With three boys of his own, fatherhood has taught Barry a lot, and he's ready to share, like never before, details of the painful relationship he had with his boxing trainer father, Ray, that shaped so much of his life.
Like any young kid, all I want to do is impress Dad, and, you know, he's a character that probably doesn't give that away.
What sort of relationship did you have with your dad?
Didn't really have a great relationship. He's very hard. Very hard man.
Desperate to please, a teenage Barry would seek attention in the only way he thought his dad would notice.
The thing that I would do was have a fight at school and go home and brag about it because I knew he'd be happy about that. And he was rapt about it. You could see the smirk on his face. It's mind-boggling now that I sit here and, as a father, think that that was okay and that I thought that that was a way of approval from him. It's bizarre.
But this violent state was all Barry knew. After school, boxing training with Dad would begin. Barry often matched against grown men.
Blood noses every night. You know, there was some times there where I thought I just didn't want to be here anymore. It was like, I don't want to do this.
Eventually, it was too much. Barry finding a way to tell his father he couldn't go on boxing.
He took it pretty hard and, he didn't speak to me for a long time. Not a word. So, which sounds unrealistic to people, but if you knew my dad, not a word.
Are we talking months?
We're talking years.
Years.
We're talking years, yeah.
A switch to football would suddenly make Barry a household name, captaining the Sydney Swans to their first premiership in 72 years. But for all the success, the trauma of childhood was impossible to slip. Barry struggling to unlearn the cycle of validation through violence.
And some of what I did on the field was ridiculous. But it was... When I sit back and think about it now, it was all approval because the first one I go to, I drive up home and, you know, he's got that little smirk that is his approval.
After seeking help and working hard on himself, Barry knew he had a very difficult decision to make.
You don't realise you're in something until you're out of it. And once I got out of it and I sort of have cut ties, no longer have a relationship, and I actually feel sorry for him. Actually, I'll detract that. I felt sorry for him until I had my own children. And then I thought, well, you know, I've spoken to some people about this and they said, well, maybe that's how he was brought up as a child. I was like, well, that's fair enough, but why am I the one to stop the cycle? Why wasn't he strong enough?
But stop it, he has. And for all his physical strength, spend a day with Barry and what stands out is his gentleness with sons Miller, Houston and four-month-old Samson.
You've got twins, you two.
He's not that ugly.
The 45-year-old has moved from Melbourne to the Gold Coast, savouring every possible moment to play with his boys.
Oh, can I have an apple, please?
Yeah, only have one apple.
Thank you very much. How much is it?
$10.
$10 for an apple.
Setting up his new home with his wife, singer and actress, Lauren Brandt.
We're a good team. We're definitely teammates in all of it. And I think the secret to us is just that we both love children. That's something we had in common right from the start.
Barry's not here to give himself excuses. He's speaking out to support and inspire others who might be struggling and remind us all to be understanding.
Everyone has a story, and I think... You know, if someone's in a bad mood at work and or something, you know, constantly happens, it's probably for some other reason that, you know, you don't know about. If speaking about it is helping, well, that's great.
With his newfound beach lifestyle, Barry has created a happy environment for his kids to grow up in.
1, 2, 3, go! Yeah!
Using his own childhood as motivation to move forward and be the father he never had.
It's given me a gift that I know what not to be. So I give probably too much love to my boys, which sounds bizarre, but, you know, they've got everything they need. You know, I dote over them, and we both do, me and Lauren do. So they've got so much love in this household, and that's how it should be.
What would you do if one of the boys came to you and said he wanted to try boxing?
No, they're too pretty. I'll leave the punching in the face for Dad.
And that happens to be Barry's next challenge. On Wednesday, March 23, as a firm underdog, he'll take on a rugby star, Sonny Bill Williams, in the first ever televised spectacle streaming on Stan Event, which is also part of the company that owns this network.
I'm here for my boys. I'm here, I'm fighting for my family, and it can really do great things for us.
For nearly 2 years, Barry has been pushing himself in a sweatbox gym south of his home, getting ready for Sonny Bill.
This is old school sweaty boxing gym in a tin shed, and in summer it gets pretty hot.
This is the real deal. So Hal, you feel you're just about in peak condition?
I'm just about in peak condition, absolutely. Yep. But I do have an issue.
Right.
So my sparring partner was meant to come, can't make it today.
Okay.
So I need someone around 100 kilos, around 6'2", that's what he is. I'll just so happen to have some gloves. And it just so happened to remember a story you did back in about 2012, I reckon.
No, Baz, I didn't mean anything by that. That was just my job at the
time. I know that, but if you can help us out sparring, that'd be great too.
Sparring with you?
Yeah.
You serious?
Yeah.
Oh. Better change then.
Get changed. Are you ready to go?
Yeah, let's do it.
What's this?
Necessary precautions, Barry. Oh, there's nothing. I didn't feel a thing. That's Sonny Bill's job, not mine.
You all right, bud?
Give me five, I'll be fine.
All right.
When's the bell go? Second round.
Let me know when you're ready.
I think he's still down.